Now is the time to showcase your gifts to the world.
Artist and lyrics. Artist and lyrics.
The gifts of a man.
This week we are having another gospel movie maker in person of Femi Adebile. We're going to review his movie, The Keeper.
Sunday YouTube.
Don't forget to follow artists and lyrics on AP Radio United Kingdom every Thursday, 5 to 5:30 p.m. as well as MZ Radio London every Thursday, 7 to 7:30 p.m. London time. Let's watch a little bit of the Keeper video and I will come back with my guest to start the conversation.
Fresh tomato, Shekowa, 3 for 20 naira. Irokole work, aye bubulawa.
All power in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. There is nothing your keeper can do.
Then you should have relied on that power to be blessed by it and not visiting the ungodly for butter and bread.
Francis, are you an ungodly person?
You should have your polluted and covetous spirit.
Yeah, thank you very much for the privilege to be on this platform. We appreciate God. My name is Femi Adebile, and people popularly call me Fejus Baba, of which my YouTube channel was named after that, Fejus Baba. So, I'm a child of God, I'm an actor, a filmmaker, scriptwriter, and also a music minister too. I was born and bred in Ondo State. I schooled in Ondo State, did my primary education in Ondo State, second education in Ondo State. They went for my first degree in Lautech to study computer science and engineering. At the same time, for my master's degree in the Federal University of Technology at Korea for my M.Tech. And so, if God will help us, we put forth for PhD. I am married, and possibly what brought me into movie making is, number one, it was an encounter. It was not just that I had passion. Yeah, I had an encounter while I was in my secondary school, especially from my senior secondary school, since 1 to 3, I began to have diverse encounters of what God wanted me to do in the ministry of drama, in the faith-based filmmaking. Yeah, so the encounter became more clearer when I left secondary school and I went to the university, that the Lord made me into filmmaking, because I discovered that anything I want to do, I always have a way of showing it. Even the little words, I know how to just dramatize my words and use my reactions, use the act to see. I'm more convinced in the act to talk than just talking verbally. It's just an encounter by the Spirit of God. It's a call of God in my life. It's not born out of passion or interest. It's an encounter because, as a matter of fact, I hate anything being done in drama. I remember that when I was in secondary school, I normally bribe my classmates for them not to put me in the end of the year ceremony drama that the school normally do. I have to give them money because I'm very, very strict. I'm a very, very strong introvert. I'm a shy person. So I can't even stand for my mates to speak. So I don't like drama. So, but I don't know how God now used the point, that weak point that I have, and made it a point of strength for the world to see and to be blessed. There are big challenges. If one begins to put that into letter, it's going to be a book. There are many that actually is capable of throwing me out of the work. There are many that can actually make me believe that it's God in it. You know, ranging from battles from close friends, battles from friends, some enemies who pretend as friends. You know, especially when God begin to bring the glory out, and when people begin to see the works, so you discover that those who were once friends are now eventually dressing back. You know, a shocking one that happened was the fact that I had my YouTube channel shut down without any offense. I was built to release a new movie on a Sunday like this. Everybody's expecting that movie on a Sunday, only for me to wake up Sunday morning and discover that my YouTube has shut down my channel. Why did they do that? Nobody knew. I was bewildered. I was not myself. I'm a very strong man. Things don't get to me, but that one got to me. I wept because I didn't know what I did. And having done all my best, you know, to contact YouTube and everything, the long and short is that YouTube eventually let me know that it is one of the people that will work together in this same consortium that went to report me to them for something I did not do, so that the growth of that channel will be stopped. Because the channel is growing. So I want YouTube to after much persuasion, they told me, go and submit for you. They said, you are not a filmmaker, you are a thief. You normally use to do movies on your channel, you are not a real ghost filmmaker. I said, I am. If you are, go and bring all the script you've ever shot. Go and shoot your studio. Go and shoot your the way your editor edits. Shoot your office. So I took a video. Thank God I have a document. So I brought my script from 2008 up to date. Arranged it on my table, camera did, shot my editing studio. My editor was working. We did that. Then location videos, location pictures. We normally do that by location. I sent them, packaged them in a video, and sent to YouTube. Then YouTube apologized to me, and eventually gave me the account name of the person who went to report me forcefully. And this person is a very close person who will say, more grace, God bless you. And at that point, I knew that we are in the midst of fools. So it's not everybody that says, God bless you and more grace, that actually want the grace to be more. It shocked me. What really shocked me is not that the fact that the channel is even down. What shocked me is the fact that when you know, you see, all of us, we are aware that we have enemies. Everybody knows there's an enemy. So what shocked us and what makes us sad is not the fact that we have an enemy. But what shocked us and makes us sad is the fact that when you now realize who the enemy is. So it's a major challenge. And what I call from that is the fact that not everybody likes your success. So I learned that do your own, do your thing, stay in your lane, just serve God and be fine. That's just one of the many challenges I can catch.
Well, thank God it was restored and you are still enjoying your YouTube channel now. So let us go to your movie, The Keeper. The movie opens on Mr. Daniel, whose spiritual life is under questioning. The story portrays him as a man whose act of begging for help from an unbeliever leads him to an unknown covenant. For me, as a born-again Christian, I don't think there's anything wrong to ask those who are not born again for help, as against when John rejects the gift from his boss because he is not born again, right? And later accepts the gift after he is born again. So, are you telling us to only accept help from born-again Christians? Or what do you want to establish about accepting favor from people?
Thank you very, very much. I like that question. The Bible says that the word of the Gentiles shall be converted to you. So that alone will let us know that it's not compulsory that all our help must come from children of God. A Muslim can help a Christian. A traditionalist can help anybody. The help can come from anybody. But in the case of Mr. Daniel, if you watch the film well, there are times Mr. Daniel has been inviting this brother to church. Come to attend our church. And you don't look like born again. Of course, Mr. Daniel knows that this man is not born again. He knows, because he keeps preaching to him as he comes to his house. You are not born again. Come to church. I pay. He said, no, you have to come to church. You have to come to church. You have to come to church. Now, you know, an unbeliever is different from a sinner. A sinner is somebody who commits sin, not because he does not believe in God. He believes there is a Jesus. In fact, a sinner believes that Jesus died for him. So therefore, he only wants to continue to sin. He knows that when the rapture takes place, he's going nowhere. That's a sinner. An unbeliever is somebody that believes that Nobody is going. It has said Mobaji Suni is a lie. There is no rapture, there is nothing. And he does not even believe anything. He met such people. He tell you, Jesus, no day. Jesus, no day. To tell you, there's nothing will happen. All of us, now fire will go. All of us, we are all thief. We are all this. You know, these ones are unbelievers. They can begin, they will pick things from you that sometimes you as a Christian may keep short and you never know what to say again. These people are like atheists. So in the life of this brother, Francis, I think Francis is the name of that guy. Mr. Daly, no, this man is not born again. He's not a Christian. You have tried to bring the life of Christ to him. He's not accepting it. There's no readiness to take the life that you have. There's no readiness to accept the Jesus that you have. Then it is wrong now to not ask that person from help. You don't know the work he does. You are not sure that, okay, listen, if I see a sinner who is in the oil company, and say, let me come, I've learned to support your ministry, I can trace it. Any oil company man is rich. Is well to do. But this somebody you don't know the source of his wealth, you don't know what he does, you only know that he lives in a very good house, he rides the best of cars, you don't know what he does, you don't know his job, he just spends money, and you decide to preach his dear to Jesus Christ. You present Christ, he says, no, 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 no. And then he asks for help. Be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. That is the Bible. He said, don't be equally yoked with them. For what relationship has light with darkness? Look at the way he hurried and was eating meat like a hungry lion. That man don't have heart. He has no, that's not decency. Now, you know, met this person, he has not given him money, he brought the chicken. The way he was eating the chicken, we let you know that this man is a look, all he wants is just the money. So, covetousness in him. So, look back. You see, Yahoo guys, they do nothing but they ride the best of cars. They do no job, you go to them, they give you money. One day they will ask for your life. In fact, they have spent this money together. So it's just to explain that. But as part of Bro John rejecting that car was not because the Oga is a sinner, but it was because the Oga was using that car as a sacrifice on God's altar. Now that car was not, Bro John, take this car, I dash you. Of course, it's his boss. But it was because Bro John has taught them the EU of altars, that part of the keys to ending altar is offering a sacrifice that will cost you much, like David in the Bible. Something that can cost you, something, maybe money, maybe land, to offer unto God. So that touched them so much. And because of the revelation Bro John gave to them, they were willing to give that car to God's altar. So giving the car to God's altar cannot be accepted when you first of all is not born again. The car was not given to Bro John. The car was given to God's altar. So Bro John not accepting the car was not because it was given to him. It was because it was under the revelation of what Bro John has shared. He now told them, of course, I taught you how to sacrifice. But the first sacrifice, according to Romans 12:1, is you present your body in sacrifice, holy and acceptable. Because if I take this car from you, and you think you are praying, God will give you a car, nothing will happen. Because your first altar, your sacrifice is not yet clean. So he tells them, go and be born again. When your body is pure, and your sacrifice is pure, is there anything you want to give to God? Yourself. So that is why he rejected me. Not because he naturally woke up one day without any lecture, any sermon, and said, Bro John, you are take, I want to dash this car. He can't collect it. But it was given, it was a sacrifice on God's altar to end his serious pattern. So it must be collected well.
I know this would be exactly the question in the mind of many people out there. And that is why we are bringing this one up. We are just asking you to add more to that information, which you have actually done very, very well. Thank you so much, sir. Now, what is your feeling about artist and lyrics?
I think it's something that is very, very good. This is the platform that's lacking for we, the gospel musicians and the drum ministers. Those in the secular have a whole lot of platforms. They have the African Magic Viewers Awards. They have a lot of, they have places they can go. They have different platforms so that they can invite them. They share themselves. But we, the truth is, we lack such platforms. We lack such,
no real award for, you know, to appreciate people who are doing well. No platform, no. Our films are not on African Magic, you know, we don't have them on African Magic Yoruba. You know, we are limited a little bit in this cosmos. But we believe that doors are opening gradually. Look at Netflix now. A lot of ghost films have gone there that have been rejected because it's projecting Christ. These are more at the different challenges that our ghost filmmakers are having. But I know that it will be long. Very soon, all those mountains are the process for Jesus Christ. So when these artists and links now, you are part of what is now doing this job of seeing how to encourage those who are working out there to bring them on board, let them see what they do, and from them, people go out to reach out to them. So it's a platform I really embrace, I love, I appreciate the mind of the set man that has brought this to be, and strictly for the, you know, the gospel artist and the gospel musician. And I believe that very soon, artists and links should be on the cables. It's going to be a very big show that, people will have to come out. In fact, even award night ceremony can also be done to encourage gospel people. So I really appreciate what you are doing. And that's what I can say. I believe that God will be with artists and links.
Well, yeah, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for that beautiful comment. Yes, it feels like we continue this conversation with our big brother, Femi Adebile, but unfortunately, the time is not on our side to stay longer than the moment we have spent with him. We just want to say thank you so much, sir, for coming on this platform to share more, to give us more insight into the movie, The Keeper. So, Nibi Bayi, Lauti Masoepe, Otun Bini Ose, Ti Ombo, Nibati Aotuwa, Elu, Enikon, Eshe Ganisa.